Hello everyone, welcome. As I mentioned in the previous videos, it's time to provide an update on Red Dead Redemption and the best way to run the game currently. We now have mods available that allow for unlocking the frame rate completely on the Nintendo Switch version. Before we continue with our video, I'd like to remind everyone that leaving a like and subscribing to the channel is essential to receive future updates.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Let's begin by discussing the version that presents more challenges. RPCS3, although an emulator that has been constantly improving, is still not viable for playing Red Dead Redemption. To run the game reasonably, you would need an updated and high-performance processor. Therefore, I won't delve into the PlayStation 3 version here, as I've covered this issue in another video, and you can check more details in the link provided in the card. Now, focusing on the Xbox 360 and Nintendo Switch versions, let's analyze all the available emulators, Xenia, Yuzu, and Ryujinx. We'll also check if it's possible to run the game on Android in the current situation. Starting with Xenia, the Xbox 360 emulator. It has a low CPU demand but requires a powerful GPU. You can play at resolutions up to 4K if your GPU is powerful enough. However, in this version, the shadow quality is slightly lower, and the rendering distance is shorter compared to the Switch version. These details should not bother those who just want to have fun with the game. The performance is good, but some settings need to be applied through patches. You'll find the updated patches in the video description. They should be placed in a folder called Patches in the root of the program. Note that there are patches for the normal version of the game, and the Game of the Year version. To run the game at 1080p, the best configuration is to use the patch for 540p with 4x MSA and apply horizontal and vertical scaling multiplied by 2 in the emulator. This will provide a jagged-free image and won't require as much from the GPU. Additionally, with these modifications, you can unlock the frame rate. Now, regarding Nintendo Switch emulators. Mods have been released that allow you to play the game with dynamic FPS, locked at a maximum of 60 FPS, and even up to 120 FPS. I'll leave a list of the mods in the video description so you can check them out. These mods work on both Nintendo Switch emulators. On the Nintendo Switch side, we have Ryujinx, which is the most accurate, but this accuracy comes at a performance cost. At native resolution, it's relatively easy to maintain frame rates above 60 FPS in open field areas with a 2020 CPU. In the city, it's still possible to easily maintain more than 40 FPS. The better your CPU, the better the performance on Ryujinx. However, many users encounter issues with this emulator. During gameplay, it usually doesn't present significant problems. But if your PC doesn't meet Ryujinx's requirements, don't worry, you can use Yuzu. Yuzu is the lighter Nintendo Switch emulator, focused on better performance and lower accuracy. It tends to run better than Ryujinx on most PCs and can be the more viable alternative if you have an older or entry-level PC. To achieve better performance on Yuzu, you'll need a robust CPU. Now, let's start with our tests. First, we'll test at the native resolution. Please note that I'm using Xenia twice. In the first run, it's running at the native Xbox 360 resolution, which is 720p for this game. In the second run, we're running it at 1080p with 4x MSA. For the Switch versions, the standard is 1080p. As I mentioned earlier, the versions are graphically different. In the Xbox 360 version, shading was done by replicating the shadow of the object on the ground, resulting in rendering every tree branch on the ground. In the version released this year, this was simplified, making it more similar to current games. Another important note is that Xenia consumes very little memory. 8GB of RAM would be sufficient to run the game even at 1080p, while the Switch version would require at least 12GB. It's also important to note that all shaders were already compiled in all emulators. To summarize the benchmark, which lasted about 3 minutes, there were some surprises. The highest frame rate still belongs to Xenia, and it also has a better 1% low rate, meaning it had fewer drops during the test. This emulator also makes maximum use of the processor, almost reaching its limit. When we tested at 4K and in more demanding scenarios, it became clear that Xenia was not designed for this. It used almost all of the GPU's capacity and managed to provide around 30 FPS, even in more open areas, consuming almost 8GB of VRAM and increasing CPU consumption. On the other hand, When using Nintendo Switch emulators, it's possible to easily maintain a frame rate above 50 in open areas, without using even 4GB of VRAM and keeping CPU and GPU consumption lower. Overall, Nintendo Switch emulators are a better choice for those who want to play in 4K. However, at 720p and 1080p, Xenia still offers better performance, especially if you have a powerful GPU. Before concluding the video, we also tested the game on an Android device, and all the specifications of my device are in the description. We used the native resolution and the handheld mode, and tested on the three available Nintendo Switch emulators, Yuzu Early Access, EggNS, and the now discontinued Skyline Edge project. In EggNS, the game runs perfectly, but after a few seconds, an error occurs. The only emulator that runs the game almost perfectly is Skyline Edge. The frame rate is good, but there's an issue with the colors, making everything appear bluish. The bad news is that the emulator is no longer in development due to issues with Nintendo, so there's no hope for color correction and decent gameplay on mobile devices. Please remember that the gameplay in the background was recorded with screen recording software, which affected performance, resulting in a frame rate between 15 and 30%. I hope the video has been helpful for you. Don't forget to leave a like, as it's very important for YouTube to promote our work. Until next time.
You them, one of them Williamson boys.
Calm down.
Go on, shoot him, mister. Shoot him.
Come what you...